Hi, my dear students, welcome to my biology class. In the previous class, we have familiarized with the taxonomic categories. Today, I am going to teach you each taxonomic category in detail. We know that classification is not a simple process. It's a complex procedure. It includes arrangement or grouping of animals or organisms based on some similarities and dissimilarities, and those are arranged in various level according to these features. Today we are going to learn more details about taxonomic categories. So today's topic is taxonomic categories. What is meant by taxonomic categories? The various grouping levels or ranks in the classification are known as taxonomic categories. In the classification, the taxonomic categories are arranged in ascending order. Which are the taxonomic categories? Do you remember? Those are kingdom, phylum, phylum for animals, division for plants, class, order, family, genus, species. Here, the species is the lowest category with the most number of similar features, while the kingdom is the largest or highest category with the more differences. Then first of all, let's learn about species. Species is a group of related individuals which have more common fundamental features, that means similar characteristic features, and are able to interbreed among themselves to produce fertile offspring. This is a biological concept of species which was given or proposed by a famous scientist, Mayer. He is popularly called the Darwin of 20th century. So let's come to the species. It comprises a group of closely related individuals. Let us think about human beings. Human beings belong to the species Sapiens. We all are closely related individuals and are able to interbreed among ourselves to produce the fertile offsprings. So that is the meaning of the word or the term species. For example, housefly, its scientific name is Musca domestica. Housefly, Musca domestica. And another example from the plant, wheat, its scientific name is Triticum aestivum. Triticum aestivum. Here the word domestica and aestivum, they represent the species name. The first two words, Musca and Triticum, are genus name, and the second word is the species name. Here the species domestica, that comprises closely related individuals of the housefly. The species aestivum, that comprises closely related individuals in that particular species. Got it? The next taxonomic category is genus. Genus comprises a group of closely related species. For example, the animals like a lion, tiger, and leopard are closely related animals. They have some common similar features. Those are closely related species too. They come under the same genus, Panthera. So look at the board. Now I'm going to write the scientific name of all these animals. First of all, lion. Its scientific name is Panthera leo. Next, leopard. Its scientific name is Panthera pardus. Then tiger, its scientific name is Panthera tigris. Okay, here The genus Panthera is common for these three animals as they are closely related species. That is the meaning of the term genus. Genus comprises a group of closely related species. I can give you one more example for the genus from the plants. Then for example, potato and brinjal are two vegetables, but they are closely related species. Morphologically, they are totally different vegetables, but they come under the same genus Solanum. The scientific name of potato is Solanum tuberosum. The scientific name of brinjal is Solanum melongena. Here, they have similarities in the anatomical features, the reproductive features or the floral patterns. But here, they are closely related. That's why they come under the same genus Solanum, which is the next taxonomic category, that is family. Family. So, how can you define the term family? Family is a group of closely related genera. Genus is the singular form, genera plural form. It's a group of closely related genera. For example, the flowering plants come under some particular genera like Datura, Petunia and Solanum. In a particular family, Solanaceae. Okay, here the Datura, Petunia and Solanum are three different genera, but they are closely related as they have some similarities in their vegetative parts and the reproductive parts, so that they come under the same family, what? Solanaceae. When we think about animals, I can give you one example from the animals too. Then for example, the genus Panthera and the genus Felis, those come under the same family, Felidae. The genus Panthera and another genus named Felis. Actually, the Felis is the genus of cats. Okay, so these two are related genera. They come under the same family, what? Felidae. Canidae is the family of dogs. Dogs come under the family Canidae. Okay, which is the next taxonomic category, that is order. Okay, here how can we define it? Then order is a group of closely related families. Here there is a specific feature in connection with the order. The order comprises related families, but they have few similarities and some more differences. What is the peculiarity when it goes to the higher and highest category? The similarities decreases and the differences increases. Here also, the order comprises a group of related families. At the same time, they also have some basic differences. Here, for example, the families like Solanaceae and Convolvulaceae. Solanaceae and Convolvulaceae. These two are the families of flowering plants. These two families come under the same order, Polymoniales. That means Polymoniales is a particular order which comprises closely related families. Why these are closely related families? As they have some similarities in their floral pattern or floral development. That's why they are come under the same order, Polymoniales. But they are extremely different in some other characteristic features. Next, one example from animals, the families like Canidae and Felidae. Felidae is the family of cats. Canidae is the family of dogs. These two are related families. They come under the same order, Carnivora. Got it? So, as they have some similar features in them, they come under the same order, carnivora. The next higher category is class. So, what is a class? What does it comprise? It comprises closely related what? Orders. For example, just before you have familiarized with the one order, that is carnivora. Here, carnivora order means those animals are carnivores. So, the order carnivora and one more order primata. Primata is an order which comprises apes, gorilla, monkeys and human beings. So, both carnivora and primata are closely related orders. These two orders come under the same class, mammalia. Why? Because they have the features of mammals. They give birth to young ones. So, they come under the class mammalia. Then the second largest taxonomic category is phylum or division. Phylum for animals and division for plants. This phylum, how can we define it? Phylum, what is phylum? Phylum is a group of closely related classes. For example, the phylum Chordata. The phylum Chordata comprises the related classes like what? Pieces, amphibia, reptilia, apes and mammalia. These are closely related classes. These are included in the same phylum what? Chordata, because they have notochord in them, dorsal hollow nerve cord in them, so that they are in the same category. They are the same phylum what? Chordata. Got it? Then finally, when we think about the largest category, kingdom, what does it mean? Kingdom. I have told you that kingdom comprises wide varieties of living organisms, different varieties of plants and animals. That means the most number of differences can be observed in the groups of kingdom. There are mainly two major kingdom. Those are the kingdom Plantae and the kingdom Animalia. Plantae and Animalia. That means the kingdom comprises a different types of phyla. For example, the kingdom Animalia consists of various phyla like Porifera, Coelenterata, Platyhelminths, Aeshelminths, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata and Chordata. All these are different phyla that come under the kingdom Animalia. Similarly, the kingdom Plantae also comprises Bryophyta, Thallophyta, Pteridophyta, Gymnosperms and Angiosperms. So, here I can say kingdom is the highest category, the largest category, which comprises mainly two kingdom. The organisms belonging to these two kingdom show wide varieties of characteristic features. And I hope you understood what are the taxonomic categories. I have explained that in detail with the help of some examples. Now let's understand how an animal is placed in the hierarchy of classification in different levels according to its similarities and dissimilarities. For example, let's take our name, Homo sapiens. Here, the species name is what? Sapiens. Sapiens is the species name. What is the genus name? Homo. Homo is the genus name. So, we belong to the family Hominidae. And this family come under the order Primata. This particular primate, the order primate, come under the class Mammalia. mammalia. See, mammalia is included in the phylum Chordata. So Chordata is one of the phyla of the kingdom Animalia. So this is the way each animal is placed in the different taxonomic category or in the rank of the classification system. That is from the lowest category to the highest category. That is from the species level to the kingdom level, species level to the genus level, then to the family level, order, then class, phylum level, and the kingdom level. Okay, did you get how is it categorized according to its features, its similarities and differences? I hope you understood the topic well, the taxonomic categories, how an animal is placed in the hierarchy of classification. So, with this, I conclude my session. Then thank you and have nice moments.